When God shut Noah in the grand old ark, he put a rainbow in the cloud. When the thunder rolled and the sky was dark, God put a rainbow in the cloud.
Charles, the Blind Boys manager, reached out and asked me about the prospect of possibly getting together with the guys and making a Blind Boys Alabama record. I was extremely excited.
Jimster, this is Justin right here. You spoke to him on the phone.
How you doing, buddy?
What's going on, man? Good to see you. You all right?
You made it
in one piece.
First friend I called out of excitement and out of need of needing him to be a part of it was Phil Cook.
We're up here in Wisconsin, where I grew up. We're surrounded by snow. There's inches and inches, about a foot of snow on the ground right now, which is incredible. So I'm here at home making a record with the Blind Boys of Alabama. This is 100% a dream come true for me. This is it.
That's so good.
Yeah.
So good.
So good.
What'd you say? Is that it?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, that quick?
We are collaborating with other people on the record. We're doing songs that have a different instrumentation, and we're doing songs that we've never done before.
Night seems to fall.
Shara Warden is quite possibly the greatest singer like on the planet Earth. She's shattering.
I had never heard the song I'll Find a Way until Justin sent it to me. As soon as he did, I listened to it and thought it was super beautiful. And then I did a little bit of research on the songwriter Ted Lucas, and he was a Detroit artist. He was a guitar player for Motown Records, and he had several bands in the late 60s. So I think it's cool that, you know, I moved to Detroit several years ago, and Justin just gave me this song from a Detroit artist that feels good.
I'm Annette Lucas. I was married to Ted Lucas, who wrote the song I'll Find a Way. This is a particularly beautiful song that was written during a time in our lives when we were struggling.
Okay, I'm a bit nervous.
Why?
Because it's so special to have you here and to get to play this for you.
It's intimidating, I guess, to sing with a blind voice because you feel the weight of history and everything that they have experienced, and I have a lot of respect for them and also for Ted. You know, it's never without trepidation that you walk into singing someone else's tune.
I play the fool.
The Blind Boys met when they were 5 and 6 years old in the 30s in a school for the blind in Alabama, and by the time they were teenagers, they were touring all over the place. They had chaperones that went around with them, and they've been on the road ever since. Jimmy and Clarence, who are two of the original members of the band, are singing on this record. The Blind Boys are 5-time Grammy Award winners. They were inducted into the Gospel Music Hall of Fame, and they received a Grammy Lifetime Achievement Award.
Jimster, who gave me this hat, it's what he wears on stage. Jimster and I sang Every Grain of Sand together. It was a really powerful song to me in a certain part of my life when I was really at a crossroads.
In the time of my
confession in the hour of my deepest need. When the pool of tears beneath my feet flood every newborn sea.
Basically the song that got me through it, to sing it as kind of a, basically a duet with Jimmy, was a touchstone in my life. It's like catching a touchdown in varsity football. I'll never forget the moment, whatever, and that.
Are you ready? Are you ready? While the Jubilee to come,
the Jubilee to come.
Guys that have been doing it for decades and decades, it makes me feel, it gives me a sense of purpose. When we're in a room, there's no age in that room. There's nothing but joy.
Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready?